if it can be copied, it will be copied. Now, that is a quote I had read recently in a book that I'm going through called Uncopyable. I think that's the title of the book. Don't quote me on it. But the author brought that point up, and it's so relevant to nowadays with technology, with software and the internet. There aren't many things that aren't that don't allow somebody to copy what you do. You know, it's very easy for somebody to buy a piece of software that can clone your blog, clone your website, maybe take the content off your website, put it on a version of theirs, and then they can claim credit for it if you don't know that it's been used somewhere else. But it's very easy for somebody to clone all your hard work, put it somewhere else, and all of a sudden now it's not just you who is writing about this topic, but somebody else is, again, copying you word for word. And in a world like that, it's very hard for you to kind of separate yourself from the crowd, because anybody can do that, and they can do it overnight, and suddenly then you aren't the one person with that content on the web or that type of book in the Kindle. So I'd imagine when J.K. Rowling had released the Harry Potter books, probably in the first couple of years, it wasn't really raising anyone's attention. But over time, as people seen that that's where all the kids were going to, that's where the money was being spent, I'm sure a lot of authors or would-be authors raced to the keyboard and said to themselves, I'm going to write a Harry Potter clone so I can make a portion of this pie. And while you can do that, there is one thing that you are never going to be able to clone, and that is the author. Now, if you know anything about J.K. Rowling at all, not only do you know that she had wrote the Harry Potter books, but you probably know a good bit of her backstory as well. You probably know how many times that book had been turned down by publishers. You probably are well aware of how destitute she was at the time, and how she was living on benefits, and that maybe she was writing the book, I don't know whether it was in coffee shops, or whether she wrote them on the train, or where it was, but she wasn't somebody who had a writing studio. She was writing wherever she could. And again, she was going through a really, really tough time, and those books were probably the thing that kept her going through that tough time. Now, while you can clone her book, there's no way you can clone that story unless you purposely put yourself through the exact same experiences as she had. You're never going to be another J.K. Rowling. Now, that brings up an important point, and it's something that I'm always telling anybody who visits my blog or anybody who is on my email list, and that is to put more of themselves into their content. You know, anybody could do exactly what I'm doing here at the moment. Anybody could pick up an iPhone, anybody could record 2 videos a day, but not everybody can make the same goof ups I make. Not everybody can speak in the same action or the same accent as I do. Not everybody can come up with the same ideas. Sure enough, you might in a couple of weeks, as you find out what content I'm producing, copy it word for word, but you can't replace me, because I am an individual. I am not a number, as the TV show said. But that's something to keep in mind, is to put more of yourself into your content, because anybody can copy your content, anybody can clone anything you do, but nobody can clone you. And the more you put yourself into your business, the more you put your thumbprint on your work, there's nobody really that can steal it. And if they do try and steal it, they will be seen for what they are, just a simple thief or somebody who is just a copycat, but not somebody who is you, because you have put your thumbprint all over your business. So think about that in your work this week. How can you put more of yourself into your marketing, telling some of your backstory, like as I said with J.K. Rowling, that story about how destitute she was, how many books or how many publishers she'd gone to with that book. All those different things are all bundled into that Harry Potter story. And I'm assumed that story has sold a lot of books for her, and has, again, just like the Harry Potter books, has separated her from all the other authors or would-be authors at that time, because they unfortunately were sitting back and they were relying on their books to do all the marketing for them. They were relying on, you know, word of mouth to go out for readers to promote the books, but never really actually put more of themselves into it or reached out to their audience. Or, you know, unfortunately, a lot of authors are a little bit on the shy side and, you know, expect their books to do all the marketing for them. When, if you want to separate yourself from the crowd, it's important that you do get your foot out there, meet your crowd, do things like I'm doing at the moment. do maybe podcasts, do maybe videos, do maybe have an email list and write to your readers regularly, but do something to put a thumbprint on your business. Because as I said, it's so easy for somebody nowadays to clone a website, to take all your traffic, to take all your content, and you know, all of a sudden then it's not just you with that content out there. There could be 10, there could be 20, there could be hundreds of sites with all that information on it. And again, when you are one of the crowd, you know, you don't stand out. So it's up to you to get your voice out there, get your face out there, get your story out there, and get that in front of as many people as you can, so it separates you from the crowd. And when somebody thinks of a particular book or whatever, it's not just all the other books that they think about. They, in their mind, picture you with that book, and when it comes for them to make a buying decision, it's not just the book they're buying, they're also buying you and your story. So think about that this week. Try and put more of a thumbprint on your business. So if somebody does try to rob your content or clone your books or your websites or whatever, how can you make sure that there's one thing in that content that they can't clone? So give that some thought this week. Now, if you'd like to know more about me, or if you'd like to know more where these videos are, you're very welcome to do a Google search, or do a search in iTunes for WriteCome, that's WriteCome.com, and you'll find the content all over the web. Or if you'd like to ask me a question and you'd like me to cover something in an upcoming video, you're very welcome to do that. You can reach me at barryjmcdonald@gmail.com, and hopefully all going well, I can cover that content in a video for you. Now, at the moment, we are giving a great report away on the website. Again, that's the WriteCome website. And I'm going to show you how anyone can go from words to wealth. I'm going to show how anyone, even if you don't have great experience as a writer, in some cases, I'm going to show you how you can make money from a handful of words, or in some cases, hardly any words at all. Now, if that intrigues you at all, or if you'd like to put my free report to the test, again, come over to the site, download it, give it a look, and if you'd like to contact me or argue with me that some of the things aren't relevant, again, reach out at the channels I've given you earlier. So, as always, take care and have a great day. Bye-bye.